Game City. I've been joined by Molly Carroll, who is the community manager, I think, yes, for Chucklefish, which is the studio that is making Starbound, which is an awesome upcoming game that looks very, very interesting. And this is your first Game City as well. You only just got here a few hours ago. How are you finding it so far?
I really love the atmosphere here, actually. Mm. It's very relaxed, and it's very kind of no stress, and there's just a lot of people with really cool things that they've created, and I think that's really neat.
Have you seen like anything else that you've liked?
I've mostly been wandering around sort of the market stalls and checking out like just crafts and things. I've really liked everything that I've seen. Like, I've been buying people's comics and things.
So, yeah. Oh, yeah. So today is the, for those who don't know, today is like a, it's like a special Game City day. There's kind of arts and crafts, things on sale. We had a bake-off yesterday, and if you've seen the cakes.
Yeah, our producer for one of our games, Rosie, she participated in that.
Oh, okay, cool. So yeah, she made the Pac-Man scones, I think.
Yeah, and the heart-shaped cookies.
Yeah, the heart-shaped cookies. Oh, they were awesome. The Zelda health pickups. So that was cool. So we've got arts and crafts, and then it's also the text day as well. So loads of games, loads of just text adventures. There's one floor where all the games are text games.
Yeah, I wandered up there. I didn't play anything yet, but I want to go back up and check it out because, I was stressing out trying to set things up before.
That's fair enough.
But yeah, I think I see a lot of kids, and it makes me really happy to see a lot of kids at an event like this that kind of shows off sort of the accessibility of making games and making things in general. Mm. I think that's really cool.
Awesome. Yeah, it's been a bit weird with the text day. Like, some older people, maybe late teens, early 20s, have been wandering in and going, oh, this is text, this is rubbish. But like, the adults who are older than that have been running in and going, oh, I remember these games. And there have been kids who've been really, really like open-minded and wanting to play them. So there seems to be like a generational thing.
Yeah.
What have you found the response has been like to the game that you've been showing, to Starbound?
We've had some people come by, some people who've already played the game in its early access state for quite a while, and they already like it, and others who just think that the concept is really cool, or they've heard about it, but they haven't really tried it because it's early access. The responses have been pretty positive. People seem to like playing it.
So do you want to, for those who don't know what Starbound is, do you want to kind of explain what the game is about and how come you've gone with the early access model?
Okay, Starbound is sort of a sandbox, procedurally generated sandbox game in space. It has just about, this is basically an infinite number of planets that the player can explore and sort of do just about anything with. We went with early access because we had spent a while in development, and we had a very large base of player, people who wanted to play the game, and they wanted to play it like now. And we had the game in a state where we felt that it was already fun. So we decided to go with an early access release. And we've had a lot of success with it, though. I mean, it's obviously a controversial thing. So I wouldn't, it's not the sort of model that you...
You wouldn't recommend it to everyone.
Yes, it's like sort of a project by project thing. But it's worked for us so far.
Have you seen any, are there any other games that you can think of that you think it's worked particularly well for?
Oh, it's almost like when you have these early access communities and you see sort of a lot of early access games, they might be doing well, but they're getting a lot of criticism. So it's hard to sort of...
Oh, okay, I see what you mean.
...judge. I mean, DayZ has obviously done really well with it. And DayZ, Rust, they've done really well with early access.
Mm. What's the plan for Starbound? Like, do you have a release in mind, or are you just going to keep going until you feel like it's ready?
We have our to-do list, and we're finishing our to-do list, and then the game is in 1.0. And after that, we're talking about making the game open source, and we have a very active modding community who... are really, they're kind of amazing. They just make amazing things that we never would have thought of for the game. And we kind of like to help them to be able to do that more, because we like seeing what they can do with what we've made. So I think, our plans are basically to finish what our to-do list is, and then we're going to keep putting out some updates and see where the modders take it to and where the community takes it.
Okay, so it's kind of just seeing how it goes and
yeah.
You don't have like a firm release in mind.
We do have, I mean, when it's actually like sort of, when our to-do list is finished, then it's sort of a final release, but then, yeah, it is basically.
And because you're going to keep updating it, presumably, yeah. So it's like an ongoing project.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like interesting, all these games that are coming out with all these different models and stuff, and Game City seems to be like demonstrating all these different kinds of games. You know, you've got people coming along and getting feedback direct from, like, have you found Game City so far compared to other events? I know you haven't been here long.
I found it just, it's sort of, I don't want to say it's the opposite of other events, but it's like, it's so low stress. It's very, it's just very chill. It's not, there's no big like marketing banners and it's not a very big space, but it's not a bad thing that it's not a very big space. Cause, I don't know, it just feels like a very kind of nice, positive environment where people are just excited about games and, about crafts and things involving games or nerdy things, and that's cool.
Awesome. Well, I should let you get back to your tiny little space so you can show the game a bit more, but okay. Thank you for coming and chatting to me. It's been really good.
Thank you. Thanks. It was good talking to you.